to the episode of Detective Pikachu. Today we're going to investigate the fog that's been going on, causing lots of weird stuff to happen around the Pokemon. They're all getting pretty sick, pretty ill. We're trying to clear some people's names. Well, we don't know if we're trying to clear their names. They might be guilty, but we'll figure that out. About the fog situation, Sprit. Yeah, the fog is making things so damn. My perfect fur is all soggy now. Oh no, it's a catastrophe! Sprit, Spritzy. Proud of Luigi, you're pretty holy, yeah, I can imagine. Are you trying to say something, Pikachu? You complaining? Oh, there's Luigi now. She smells good. What brings you here? I saw the place and just got a bit worried. Oh, I didn't realize there was so much going on at the lake. You wouldn't happen to know anything about the whole incident, would you? No, not really. I don't think I'll be much help. I was off the island for a bit because of work. I see. Oh, they said the bridge to the lake is closed. Better to stay away for now, I think. So Brad was right about one thing. He might be right about the other stuff. We can't quite call things a lie yet. Look, it's Tropia, sweet neck. He is so cute. Oh, I was hoping we'd be able to approach him because he was in the background, but luckily we can talk to him. This is a Pokemon, right? It looks like a tree. It says it can fly with the leaves on its back. How interesting. Oh, you're giving us the fruit on your neck? Pew! Wow, that smells good. I could eat a whole bucket of these. Alright, so not much help, but he gave us bananas, so I guess that works. At least they look like bananas. So I can appreciate that.
Tim, look! Look what it just gave me. This is delicious. Tim, water. Bring me some water.
Do y'all ever have the struggle where, like, you'll be drinking water, but then you choke on your water, and then you can't have water to undo the choking of the water? Just me, maybe it's just me. I don't know, I'm a special. I somehow manage to choke on water. I don't know how, and it happens more often than I like to admit. What can I do for you about the fog situation? Walls is suspected of being the perpetrator of the fog mystery. Lieutenant Brad seems to be intent on finding proof before the boat leaves. That means we can't dilly-dally. The bridge ahead is collapsed. The area is unsafe, so it would be best for you to stay away. About Brad, the lieutenant is very dedicated to his work. He works passionately to bring peace to Rhyme City. I guess he's not a bad guy. No, I think he's okay. I think he's just trying to do his best to look out for the safety of the people and Pokemon. You're the detective that solved the PCL case, right? Oh, you're quite the celebrity now. Hey, don't make fun of me. I was thinking this was a boring island, but if you're here, maybe something interesting will happen. Alright, so detective, do you think Walls is the culprit? No, there's no evidence, so I can't say. You're cautious, aren't you? I can't go against Lieutenant Brad's orders, but if there's anything I can help with, let me know. The bridge has fallen down and can't be crossed. Wait until the fog clears. He's not a bad person, but he's not very flexible in his thinking. He might find it hard to get promotions being like that. I see. Oops, don't tell anyone I said that, okay? The lieutenant can hold a grudge. Am I the only one who thinks this guy probably won't get promoted anytime soon either? Look at these creepy eyes flying around everywhere.
Hello.
Hey, Tim, did you see something over there? Oh no, the fog is thick. I can hardly see anything. I could have sworn something was watching us. Maybe I'm just imagining things. No, I see it. There's definitely something watching us, but what do we do about it?
Hey, Tim.
The bridge is broken and looks like it's going to stay that way for a while. I guess we don't have a choice. Let's head back to town and ask around to see if there's another way to the lake. But I see eyes there. Have you seen any, do any of these kids have anything else to say? I was wondering if they would have noticed the eyes as well, but it doesn't look like it, so I guess we'll head back to town. Tim, wait up. What's up, Milo? Actually, there is a way you can get to the lake. Oh, really? I heard about it when I was a kid, that there's a secret path that leads to the lake somewhere on this island. I see, I hope we can find some hint as to where it is. Apparently, they always took something with them when they went to the secret path. Maybe a hint is hidden in there. Something, huh? For the time being, let's ask people who seem like they know a lot about the island. Aye, thanks, Milo. Okay, so a secret path is what we're looking for next. Alright, let's find some people. Is this it? Kinda looks like a path. Maybe it's the one. Maybe there's more. But let's go ask the townspeople about it, see if they know much information. And if they don't tell us the information, we'll voice it out of them. Wait, do you know what? About the secret path, did you come from the lake? But how did you get there when the bridge is down? Maybe to the secret path, or... Oh, you just signed out for the lake, huh? Aw, oh, crazy, the water tape. I wonder, does the Ducklet's injury have anything to do with the case? It says it doesn't remember how it got hurt very well. Alright, I guess we'll talk to the townspeople here too. I do know there's been thick fog covering the area since about a week ago. Then again, the only people who went up there were old folks anyway. I guess the other townspeople don't really have a reason to go to the lake, huh? A secret path, huh? Can't say I've heard of it. Well, that's that. Let's ask the others. Oh man, no information from that dude. What do you want to know about the fog situation? I've been hearing strange rumors ever since the fog started coming in around the lake. What kind of rumors? Something about a monster with huge eyes appearing, what? All I'm saying is watch yourself if you plan on heading up to the lake. The secret path, whom I know I've heard of that somewhere, but what was it about? That's not very helpful at all. Well, maybe Azumarill knows.
Azumari.
About the fog situation, you were attacked by something at the lake. If you don't remember, that's fine. Sorry to remind you of a scary thing. Don't worry, we'll get the one responsible for this. No, I don't think it's underwater. Humans can't really stay underwater that long. Do you know anything? What's wrong about the fog situation? Nobody really knows why the lake has been suddenly covered by thick fog. It's not like the weather's bad or anything, so it could be the cause. Sounds like something strange is happening at the lake. We'd better check it out. I think we know that already. Secret path, I feel like I've heard that mentioned before. I'm sorry, I don't think it'll come back to me anytime soon. I maybe the Timbers know something. I mean, technically, they're carrying something right now. Burr, it says it doesn't like the fog since they can't see very well and the fog hides smell too. I wonder what's causing the fog anyway. You want to check it out if the wood there is good for chaining. There's such a good thing as good wood for chaining. Also, you grow older. As you grow older, you switch to larger logs, huh? They really do like chaining, don't they? Maybe this helps. There's a monument. Look around, though. It's kept very clean. It must be something... Okay, maybe there's a path over here to lead somewhere? You're the one I talked to already. Have I spoken to you? Alright, about the fog situation. The chief told you not to go near the lake when the fog comes in, huh? He just doesn't want you to get hurt. And you want to train even more the secret path? Not sure what that's what it's for. Oh, wait. It says the bulletin board. Okay, for timber transport and his records. Isn't there a map around here, too, somewhere? About the fog situation, I guess it'll be difficult to fix the bridge while the fog is still so heavy. Yeah, probably a bad idea. The fog's so thick we wouldn't be able to see what we're doing. I guess the secret path or whatever is our only hope of getting to the lake. Oh, I remember going through that path as a kid. We used to have a lake festival here back in the day. We'd go to the lake, do the secret path to participate. This was way before we built the bridge, of course. Oh, I see. When the day of the festival came around, the grown-ups would pass out scrolls to all the kids. Those scrolls would have riddles on them that would help them get through the path. You wouldn't happen to have one of these scrolls, would you? No, sorry. This is from way back when I was a kid, but the old man who used to hand out the scrolls around here might still some lying around. Then again, he might not even remember any of this. A scroll, huh? Well, it's the only lead we got. Let's go ask the old man in town. Wait, where's the old man? Can't say I remember what the scroll said. I do remember that we had to solve some sort of riddle to get through the secret path. The old man in town should know more about this. Alright, so where's the old man again? They're all delivery boxes. Let's check the map. Okay, nothing there. Man, did you have any information? Contacted the boss, or you don't have any information? And have I talked to the Wingull about this? About the fog situation? Fog so thick you can't even get close, huh? I wonder what caused it about the secret path. Look for you from the sky. I hope you realize I am using your wings. About the fog situation, the winter pokemon Oh, you want to take on our little child? Oh, Chris, I'm so happy you're interested in your culture. Wait one moment, let me go get this girl for you. Oh, it's a cute little event. I kind of wish I could go there. Take on Nemo. Well, I guess we're about to. Oh, this is the school I was talking about. Go on, take it with you. Thank you very much. Alright, nope, I didn't pick it again. What kind of room is? Alright, about the school. Thank you very much for giving us the school. Don't mention it around. The festival is an important part of our culture here. You young folks should learn all about our little island. Alright, go to school. Let's have a look. There are deep pictures and then some sort of instructions written on it. Is this a clue to the secret path? I imagine so, but first we need to actually find the secret path. Oh, sorry, forgot about that bit. Listen closely now. The two scales will guide you to the secret path. Remember that. The two scales? What do you mean? Oh, if I told you that, it wouldn't be a challenge now, would it? Finding the path is the first step. Well, good luck out there. I guess no choice. We'll have to figure out what the two scales means and find the path for ourselves. That secret path the old man mentioned has to be on this island somewhere. Let me know if you find anything that might be a clue. Let's give it a try. Say something to me. I don't see anything around here that has anything to do with a secret path. If you find anything, let me know. I think this is something to do with it. This monument. What's up, Tim? Something catch your eye? Look at this Pikachu. This design that's been carved into the monument. Does not look like a scale? How do you mention? Oh, of course, the number of scales carved into the monument is what we're looking for. The entrance to the secret path has two scales. This monument has three scales, so this is the right one. There must be monuments in other places too. Let's have a look. I'm a genius! I figured it out. Oh, yeah, let's look for another monument. I'm pretty sure I saw one over to the right. Maybe by Wall's house? Or maybe not. I guess we're about to find out. Hey, can I talk to you about anything? I wish I could say that as a Pokemon Ranger, I know all about the sound, but I don't know any monuments. I feel like this is a place of interest, Pikachu. There are a lot of rocks kicking around here. Do you think it could have been a statue? And it wouldn't surprise me, which means it may have some scales carved into it. Oh, Tim, let's have a look here. Two scales, no doubt about it. This is the entrance to the secret path. Hey, Tim, you found the secret path. You gotta take me with you. This is kind of obvious. Oh, of course, the entrance is just beyond here. Come on. Alright, let's go. And Milo's gonna come with us. Secret path. Oh, are those actual tropias or the statues? There's Feebas here, too. So, this is the secret path. It looks really convoluted. Oh, if we can figure out what the scroll's saying, we'll be able to follow the path. Without getting lost, right? Let's have a look at that scroll for Stades. Oh, okay, yellow circle. This must be a full moon. Half circle in the sky. This must be half moon. Oh, maybe the shape of the moon is some sort of clue. The shapes of the moon. A black circle as if there's a hole in the sky. Now what would this mean? Well, that's common sense. No moon in the sky. So in other words, a new moon. Oh wait, the three moons, but there's something else that I've been wondering about. Each picture of the moon is a different color. Green, pink, and blue. These colors must be a clue too. Alright, colors and different sceneries as well, like forest, water, and I'm not sure what this is. What does it say down here? Let me see. The night of the full moon is the beginning. Pass through the shadows of darkness, and when thou witness the split moon, the lake shall bestow its blessings. Sounds like some kind of riddle. Plunge in here, let's see. If thou wishes to reach the lake, follow the light of the moon and face the tree challenges. What do you think that means? Follow the light of the moon, huh? That's not an important clue. My name is Pikachu. Alright, the night of the moon is beginning. Pass through the shadows of darkness. I think that's all we're going to glean from just looking at the scroll. We still need more information. There might be some clues along the secret path as well, like those Pokemon statues in front of each path. I bet they're important. A good point. Well, though, let's go look at those statues. Now I'll make a note of anything we notice about the statues in the case list, too. Let me help, too. If it's anything about Pokemon, I'm your go-to guy. Which path? Okay, maybe. Milo's helping us out. Thank you. About the Pokemon statues. Each pot has a Pokemon statue in front of it. There's some Pokemon I've never seen before. Do you know about them? Yeah, I got this. Is there anything you need to know just to ask? Alright, first one. Tropius, this green laser is really well made. It's almost as if someone just shrank a Tropius and put it here. Oh, there's a V-Bass here too. It might be useful. I need to find a way over to it. I didn't realize I can only walk in certain parts of the land. Oh, is this a Stunfisk? What's this brown Pokemon statue? That's a Stunfisk. You'll find a lot of them near the water. They'll give you a jolt of electricity if you step on one, so be careful. There may be some around here. Be careful, Pikachu. Just who do you think you're talking to? You should be the one to keep an eye out. I bet he's gonna walk into one.
Huh? What is that?
Self-professed island protector.
This looks really bad.
It's still alive, right?
So it's you again.
What?
Pull yourself together, buddy. This happens to you all the time. You need to be more careful. There. All better.
But it still doesn't look so good.
Nah. V-Bass just look like that. It's their natural state.
Is that so?
He just insulted his appearance? It's
cute. Enough.
It's dangerous out there with all this
fog.
Excuse
me, Tim.
So you should really stay put.
He's adorable. I feel hurt by his comment.
It seems to be anxious about something.
You're right. Let's see what it has to say.
Yeah.
What are you so riled up about? The fact you made a horrible comment. You said that he still looked bad and he looks amazing. This is like... Is it the dark circles around the eyes? Is that it? I mean, everyone gets them, and I mean... happens, not much you can do. Well, the lake's in trouble, you need to get back, but what if you get hurt again? I know, V-Bass, so we're heading to Lake 2, why don't you just come with us? About the Pokemon statues, do you know anything about the statues around here, V-Bass? It says they look like they were modeled after Pokemon that live on this island, but it doesn't know what they have to do with the scroll. Okay, we'll have to have a look and see what we can find out about its wounds. Are your wounds okay? That's good to hear. What in the world happened anyway? You were swimming in the lake when something suddenly threw you. What in the world is going on? We need to get to the lake quickly and figure out what's happening. About the fog situation. Phoebe. You've been living in the lake a long time, but you've never seen anything like this before. Even the Pokemon that live here don't know what's causing the fog, huh? I think we got the information we can about Phoebus. Yeah, I've seen it at the lake from time to time. It doesn't look like much, but it's really reckless. No one gets hurt in one way or another. I couldn't just leave it. Sounds like a bit of a trouble. Why is everyone insulting it? It's so cute. Tropius is a Pokemon that's usually found in warmer regions. There's one that's always come to walls guaranteed, too. I was really surprised when I first saw it. I mean, its wings are green leaves. Some of us use their natural brown color to hide in the mud. Be careful and step on one or they'll zap you with their electricity. My detective eyes will be perfect for that.
Need help?
I'm just trying to talk to V-Bass again.
Beep.
Alright, I guess we'll check out this statue right here. Do you think this statue was a Pokemon statue too? Tiny cells and salt busted up, but there's some blue coloring left. Alright, there's two paths to take, and I'm not sure which one to take. We've checked all the statues in this area. Let's try and figure out that riddle on the scroll. Oh, you're right. Which path?
We've checked all three statues. Tell me, does the scroll mean anything to you?
What's the relationship between the scroll and the statues? The tree, moons, jaw, and the three colors on the scroll. The mysterious writing on the scroll. Statues aren't always the same size as the real Pokemon. Are the same color as the real Pokemon. Wait, what were the colors again on the sheet? Pink, green, and blue. Green. Blue for water, maybe? Pink? Three moons? I'm not totally sure on this like, aren't always the same size as real Pokemon. The chain moves around the scroll. Maybe it goes from like size, the size of the statue counts for the size of the moon. I don't think this is it. Okay, that's a fail.
No, that's not right. Something not clear? Then you should check your case list.
Lily, maybe it's colors and...
Do you think that's right?
Of course. I thought that might be it, but I was like, the colors don't match right.
One of the pictures that's on the scroll has a background the same color as a statue. So let's take the path of the statue that has the same color as on the scroll. According to the scroll, there are three trials. The question is, which color do we choose? The scroll should have clues for us. So go ahead and check in your case list.
I'll see what are the three colors. Green, pink. Oh, it's more purple, but blue. Wait.
Something seems a little off. Read the scroll carefully and then go from there. Go ahead and check in your case list.
Wait, what? I'll see what are the three colors. Wait, do you mean like the colors here? I mean the green ones on this side then. Is this what you mean? I'm getting so confused, I don't get the question!
Something seems a little off. Read the scroll carefully and then go from there. Go ahead and check in your case list.
Oh, wait, yeah! Now I remember, didn't I say, like, take the path of a certain moon first? Oh, wait, I can check my case list. Scroll. Can I get a close-up at it? Wait, text? If thou wish to reach the elite, follow the light of the moon. Face the three challenges. Green, pink, blue. Full moon, half moon, new moon. My text on the bottom. Night of the full moon is the beginning. Pass through the shadows of darkness. Oh, okay. I was confused what they were trying to ask me. Okay, full. Okay, full. And no moon. And half moon. Oh, wait. I'm done.
If we put the moons in the same order as on the scroll, you'll get full moon, new moon, and half moon. And their background colors are green, blue, and then pink. Now we know which path we need to take. We'll start with green. Does that make sense to you?
Which path does the green on the scroll indicate? Isn't that the one Tropius?
Alright, Tropius is a green one. That means we take the path with Tropius' statue.
Path with the Tropius statue. Alright, got it. Okay, where is the Tropius on? Okay, it's over here, so we'll follow it. I didn't even realize there's a path over here. I thought there was only two.
Sure this is the right way?
I think so.
I'm not worried. I'll solve the puzzles and breeze through this maze.
Pikachu, look underneath you.
Huh? What?
Danger, don't touch.
Pikachu, get out of there.
Watch out for Sunfish electric shocks. Come on, Pikachu.
Here we go.
He did it!
Whew. That was a close one. Thanks for that, Tim.
Kinda wanted to see what happened if I just let him get shocked, to be honest. Glad you're okay, Pikachu. Petal Sunfish were too slow with their little shocks. I'm forking their own, Tim. Let's check out the scroll and see what the second color is. Which is the second path? Alright, can I talk to these guys? About the fog situation, the fog isn't very filling. Well, yeah, it's not like it's gotten candy or anything. And talk about close, I don't know what their deal is. I'm pretty sure they got angry because you stepped on them, Pikachu. I know, right? I'll be more careful. I mean, then don't stand in the middle of the path, guys. With all the electricity, is a smiling man. That's kind of creepy. They say that Pokemon keep playing from the lake almost every day now. And that makes it hard for Sunfest to live in peace, too. Hey, do you think you could teach me how to produce electric shocks? Don't scoff at me, how rude! Alright guys, I'm gonna end this episode off here, so thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I will see you guys again in the next one.